I'm going to have to repeat the earlier presentation for the benefit of our guests from the ministry and the NGT. In the last 2.5 days, people in this room and many more who are not here today discussed and debated what is wrong with the rivers of the Ganga Basin, what needs to be done, how it can possibly be done, and finally, yesterday, a number of people gave very specific suggestions on the way forward. You may be aware that we intend to produce a citizen's report on the state of River Ganga. So all these deliberations on the way forward will be the last chapter of that report. So in the previous session, we had reported back to the House what suggestions had been made. Thereafter, we got a number of excellent suggestions that had been missed out earlier. Unfortunately, I won't be able to add them because there was no time gap between the two sessions, but we will add them in the citizens' report. Let me try and quickly go over these suggestions. We begin with the broad objectives that were set forth. The first one was that Ganga should be free-flowing and pristine from Gaumukh to Ganga Sagar by a certain date. The date has not been defined. Rivers must be able to perform their natural functions. Subaltern lives and livelihoods have to be prioritized. Dams and barrages for hydropower need to be understood as outdated technologies. And Ganga belongs to people, and all decisions regarding it must be taken by local people and communities. Emphasis on resource conservation before resource exploitation. I may add here that some of the suggestions that we have received, it was also proposed that they be re-looked at because some of them may not be very practical. The first set of suggestions that I would like to present are on Aviralta, on the issue of Aviralta. And here one of the key issues is to restore the flows in our rivers. In the short term, which is about 1 to 2 years, the suggestions are to cancel all proposed projects in the river basin. Jo abhi nahi bane hai, unko rok dijiye, khatam kar dijiye. Second, stop construction of all projects under construction in the 6 head streams of the Ganga. This is proposed by G.D. Agarwal also. Ensure reflows from existing projects, redesign of outlets and release regimes. This is very critical for the survival of many species that are sensitive to sudden releases from dams. Use existing storages to achieve eflows. In the medium term, 3 to 10 years, decommission old and useless dams. It seems that there are many dams where the water is not utilized. There's too much water stored, which is not utilized. An example was given of the Bansagar Dam. Second, we need to improve base flows into our rivers. And for that, it's important to begin with removing floodplain encroachments as per court orders. Many states have done nothing about these court orders. Second, initiate National Springs Revival Program, something that some of the ministries in the government of India, I think, are interested in. In the medium term, change of cropping patterns and methods to reduce irrigation demand. Isme ek aur suggestion bhi aaya tha na? Efficient irrigation systems. Change of cropping patterns and methods to demand to reduce irrigation demands continues for the longer term also. Then, let me see, did I miss something? No. urban areas and industries to undertake rainwater harvesting and recycling of wastewater, which would continue beyond the short term into the medium term. The groundwater extraction should be reduced. And again, the suggestions are at the household level, industry and agricultural use. When we come to the issue of Nirmalta, the first theme is ensure pollution-free rivers, for which existing STPs to function effectively, PPP mode, which I think the ministry is considering already and is experimenting with this. And there has been a complaint is often heard that many of the STPs don't work efficiently because they don't have power. Nowadays, there is the possibility of setting up on-site power generation through solar power. Treat the pollution at the source rather than convey it over long distances into rivers. So DWATs for residential areas, ecosand toilets. In the medium term, revise water quality standards. Not only water quality standards, but I think we have missed out on the water quality parameters also. ETPs for industry and recycling by it. Ensure pollution-free protected zones, particularly where industrial waters are concerned. On policies and institutions, there is a strong recommendation that we have a national rivers policy, because rivers are not just water. What we have is a national water policy, so we require a national rivers policy. Then there is the suggestion for a national urban water policy, because the urban demand is also rising, and with the rapid increase in urban population, this creates a lot of stress on our rivers. The second issue concerns data management. There is a strong suggestion to create an independent hydro data gathering institution, just like the US Geological Survey. Water budgeting should be done. Decisions should be made at the village, block, tehsil, district and tributary levels. And in the case of institutions, to create autonomous, empowered, transparent and accountable Ganga River Management Board or Council in the short term. And after seeing its experience, then in the medium term, create similar boards, management boards for other rivers in the Ganga Basin. It's also thought, many of us think very strongly, that none of these things are really possible unless we relook at our overall economic development policies, and we must consider a shift from the focus on growth for growth's sake to sustainability and equity. Aur isme ek sujhav ye bhi tha ki Bharat mein tel to hamare paas hai nahi, gas bhi hum import kar rahe hain, and yet we are pushing growth based on industries which require these resources. Or we need to look at a completely different model, looking at the resources that the country has, which is lots of fertile land, good rainfall, we have good knowledge, traditional knowledge systems, we have good forests, we have people. Put these resources for our economic growth, and we are likely to get a more benign growth pattern. We also need to junk harmful development plans like interlinking of rivers, inland waterways, and riverfront development. We need a comprehensive Ganga policy and law to acknowledge that Ganga rivers, I would say all rivers, have natural rights. And I'm sure you are aware of the judgment recently passed by the Uttarakhand High Court, which is languishing now in the Supreme Court, which has been challenged and is languishing in the Supreme Court. When it comes to regulation, A recommendation from the Mihir Shah committee report has also been endorsed here, which is to disband the CWC. Before we can do good regulation, we need good information, we need good data, therefore we need more granular data. Examples are that of aquifers for aquifer management, fish catch, etc. Data should be made publicly available. I think this secrecy on the Ganga data is really needs reconsideration now in this day and age when not much can be kept secret anyway. Data sharing between basin nations. This has been a strong request that when we say basin level management, that the basin level management should no longer be restricted only to the area within the country. But since Ganga is a transboundary river, we need to involve all the basin nations in various aspects of management. Better water quality parameters, biomonitoring, and special focus on agriculture and industrial pollutants. Finally, we need a committee to evaluate comprehensive environmental impact assessment of existing dams and barrages. On ecology and biodiversity. First theme is biodiversity conservation. We need to establish protected zones in origin stretches of all major rivers and tributaries. This is a suggestion taking off from the Bhagirathi eco-sensitive zone. But even downstream in the rivers, we need protected stretches which may have special biodiversity characteristics. The proposal for effective design and construction of fish ladders has also been made, but this may begin with a research program first. There's some doubt whether there can be effective fish ladders. Restoration of catchments, massive people-centric watershed regeneration program all across the upper catchment of Ganga River Basin to be undertaken in the short and medium term, and later extended to the entire watersheds. And there is the issue of sediments management, very critical for Ganga River. No use of machinery to extract sand and boulders from riverbeds. Some other issues that are more of a supportive nature to all this. One is the issue of education. In the short term, it is suggested that the science and engineering curricula in the country have ecology as a core subject. And later, in the medium and long term, ecologically trained and sensitive engineering education should be implemented. On the community action front, it's proposed that community river relationship building begin, especially in these days when a lot of migration is taking place. New entrants into our cities don't have that sense of ownership of the local rivers. Secondly, monitoring and reporting of sand mining activities can be done by communities. Research, life in rivers, plants and animals and other river processes should be studied and documented in a scientific manner. We need to study and monitor climate change impacts on River Ganga for informed decision making. And floodplain zones need to be defined. We need to quantify ecological services so that payment for ecological services is done, particularly to the Himalayan states. We have not been able to prioritize these suggestions, nor to record various nuances that were suggested. But as I mentioned earlier, all these will be recorded in the citizens' report. Thank you.